And for more on the Justice Department's probe into the interview of convicted felon Jovito Palparan, we're now joined by Justice Undersecretary for Corrections, Deo Marco. Undersecretary Marco, good afternoon to you, and thank you for joining us today. Really appreciate you coming to the show.
Good morning, Carmina. First of all, I'd like to apologize. I'm in Bucor right now, so reception might not be very good.
No, perfect. I mean, at least you're there and you get to really see firsthand what indeed had happened. So first of all, before we go on with the interview, I want to ask you, what is the DOJ's opinion of the interview that had just happened?
Okay, first of all, we did not know about the interview. There was no, DOJ did not receive any request for any interview from any media entity, and even from any PDL. So we were surprised yesterday, the Secretary and I were surprised that there was that interview. So right now, I was given instructions by the Secretary to get to the bottom of it and try to get as much information as I can. That's okay. Why I'm here also. So, yeah, I've already asked the Bureau Court to submit to me a report, but I wanted to meet with them face-to-face. That's
yeah.
Why I'm here.
All right, before you continue, so we're going to talk more about that later on. But first, I want to get the DOJ's opinion of what had happened. What do you think? What do you make sense, or how do you make sense of what had happened?
Can you say that again, Carmina? Sorry, I did not catch the last part.
What is your opinion of the interview? The fact that it happened, Undersecretary?
Right.
Go ahead.
Yes, okay. The opinion on what happened, about what happened. Okay. There's nothing actually, it's not prohibited. Having media interview PDLs is not prohibited per se. There's a provision for that in the Bucor manual. There's a provision for that under the law. But as I mentioned before, there's a requirement to go through certain procedures. And that's what we wanted to know. If the procedure was followed by SMNI, and what were the criteria used by Bucor in approving said interview. So that's what we're trying to find out.
And so far, what have you discovered?
Okay, I have discovered that there was SMNI has been requesting for said interview as early as December, and it was not granted because of the pandemic. That was the height of the Omicron virus, but it was after the alert level. It was after the transition to alert level one when they revived the request, and finally the Bucor allowed the interview to proceed. And as to the actual letter or what were supposed to be the subject of the interview, we don't know that yet. That's going to be part of the investigation. That's going to be part of what I'm trying to find out here.
Yeah, glad that you mentioned that, because a request cannot stand alone. There must be a reason behind that request, right? So what, based on the parameters set, based on the rules set by the DOJ as well, what are acceptable reasons for requesting such an interview to happen, Undersecretary?
Reasons why an interview may be conducted is quite broad, but there are reasons why it may not be granted and enshrined in the Bucor Prisons Manual. For example, when the interviewer refuses to comply with the requirements or the protocols of the Bucor, or if, for example, the interviewee will not be able to conduct to attend the interview because he's unfit or mentally or physically, or when the person has pending cases, that actually depends on the circumstances. It's a case-to-case basis, Carmina, yeah.
All right, so let's go back to the fact that you weren't informed that the interview was going to take place. Is that part of the protocol as well, or does it end with a Bucor?
Okay, the usual process, what the media entities usually do is write a formal letter first, either to the Bucor or to the DOJ. But in this case, it did not reach us, so it was limited between the media agency and Bucor. So it did not reach us. It did not reach me or my office or Secretary Guevara. Because of RA 10575 is the law which transcends the Bucor. It limits actually the power of the Department of Justice in terms of supervision over the Bucor. Instead of supervision and control, we are limited to just overseeing that the Bucor is performing its mandate and not doing anything against the law, outside the bounds of the law. It's considered, the question is now is, whether or not allowing the media to interview a certain PDL, is that an operational matter, a part of day-to-day activities? My answer is yes. So that is within the jurisdiction or power authority of the Bucor to decide.
So the fact that you weren't informed about the said interview doesn't necessarily mean that that can be taken as a violation.
Hello, sorry, I did not. Sorry, can you say it again? Sorry.
The fact that you and Justice Secretary Manardo Guevara were not informed of the said interview, that doesn't necessarily mean that that was a violation.
Oh, well, I'm not saying that. The Director General is given quite big latitude in determining or making a decision whether or not such a request may be granted. So it really depends. He's in the best position to determine if he should allow or deny such a request. I mentioned earlier about RA 10575 that we are limited to overseeing, you know, just limited to just making sure that the Director General is not doing anything that's outside the bounds of the law. But there's also a provision there which also gives the Department of Justice the power to review, modify, or reverse any act of the Bureau Corps in terms of regulatory, in the exercise of regulatory functions. But in this case, even though we could have, told Director General that this might not be a possibility, or this might not be a good idea to allow this interview to happen, we did not receive any notice from the Bureau Corps, so it's almost moot. It's moot and academic, so we cannot exercise that power anymore.
Mm.
So, but we are not saying that, you know, the Director General could violated any provisions, any law right now. So that's what we're trying to find out by getting the facts.
Okay, what about, as the interview is ongoing, Undersecretary Marco, what power does the Bureau Corps, or even the Justice Department, have over any interview, for that matter, as it is ongoing? Are there specific topics that can be discussed, certain topics that should not be discussed, pertaining, of course,
right,
to any case? Go ahead.
In fact, before they approve it, before the Bureau Corps can approve such a request, the question is the topics that
are to be discussed. I'm sorry, Undersecretary Marco, sorry to cut you there, but can you sort of shift your position a bit because your line came in faint? Your voice was coming in faint. Can you try talking to us? That's perfect. Go ahead. You were saying.
Okay. All right. Okay. So that's part of the criteria that the Bureau Corps will be using when you ask for an interview. You have to include in that written statement, the written letter, the topics that are to be discussed in the interview. So that's one of the reasons. If there's a topic there that would cause any problems as far as the Bureau Corps is concerned, or Director General is concerned, he may outright tell the interviewer not to include this topic, or maybe deny the application altogether.
Mm-hmm.
So during the actual interview, if the interviewer goes beyond what was supposed to be the topic for the interview, the Bureau Corps can immediately step in and stop it. So I think that's within their power.
All right. So we go back to the request.
Hello?
Yeah, Undersecretary, I'm still here. So we go back to the request that, as
Hello?
You mentioned, Undersecretary, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So we move on. You said a while ago that the requests were made as early as December. Have you seen a copy of those requests? And what were the topics that were included in those requests?
I just got here. Actually, I just got here. There was we're preparing for the meeting now. There's all the directors are here, except for the Director General Bantag, but different directors from different services are here. That's one of the things that we're going to talk about.
Actually,
that's number one on the agenda. But I have not seen the paper yet. Before I leave this place, I'm going to be able to find it, and we'll discuss it also.
Okay. But the interview has aired already. We know the topics that were discussed. They discussed Secretary Laila De Lima. There were allegations made. At one point during the interview, Jovito Palparan was even lauded by the government official interviewing him. At one point even saying, there was another person there that saying that he was quite legendary in his fight against the communist rebels. Is this something that the Justice Department approves of?
No, I don't think so. But whatever I find out here, I'm sure the Secretary has already seen the interview or the news report. But whatever I get from my meeting here, I'll be reporting that to the Secretary, and I will be asking for guidance from him.
All right. But as we speak right now, what were the rules violated?
Right now, we cannot say that for sure. As far as we know, when it comes to whether the question and whether or not it is allowed, the interview is allowed, my answer is yes. It is not prohibited as long with the caveat that there, as long as the interviewer or the interviewee gave his consent and the interviewer asked for approval from the Director General or the Superintendent.
Finally, Undersecretary Marco, in that interview, you had a government official saying the general is behind bars because of trumped-up charges. How can this not be seen as a government official making a mockery of the system she swore to uphold?
Well, there is that opinion. During my interview earlier, there was they're questioning the propriety of that interview, but I would rather not comment on that. I would rather stick to the law on whether or not the agency under the DOJ has violated any existing law or rules. So I'll be limiting my comment to that. I hope you understand.
I understand, and I perfectly appreciate you trying to answer that question. I also want to ask you if you're also going to look into any liability that the network may have, SMNI conducting that interview. And are you also going to look into the request if it stated there that they were going to conduct a live interview, Undersecretary?
Yes to both questions. We will look into that, to both, not only the Bucor, but also SMNI. So Okay. Everything, we have to look at all angles.
So if you're going to look into SMNI, what possible violations may have been committed by the network?
Hello?
Undersecretary.
Hello, I'm sorry. I did not get that part.
Okay.
Sorry.
If you're going to look into the network and possible liabilities,
hello?
What possible liabilities may that be? Undersecretary? Undersecretary Marco?
Hello, Carmina. Hello.
Yeah. Hi. Can you hear me? One final question before I let you go. Is my line clear now? Undersecretary Marco? Okay. I think we have lost our connection with Undersecretary Deo Marco of the Justice Department. To be fair, he did say during the beginning of the interview that he is currently at the Bureau of Corrections, currently investigating what had happened. Of course, we're talking about the interview with General Jovito Palparan of SMNI Network that was aired live via Facebook. He's going to look at the possible violation that may have been committed by the network, as well as the Bureau of Corrections. He's going to, as he said a while ago, look into all the possible angles, including the topics, including the requests that were made as early as December of last year. So we're going to have to leave that there. That was Undersecretary Deo Marco of the Justice Department. He is Undersecretary of Corrections.